So we would get a higher maybe antibody levels circulating, but with regard to the T cells, only our vaccine is likely to bring in T cells into the bladder.
Are there likely to be any side effects of using this type of vaccine?
I mean, we haven't done the necessary studies, but I don't think we expect side effects. I mean, we, as I said earlier, the FMH protein has been shown to be efficacious when it's injected into muscles. So there's not much toxicity associated with that. And the CPG protein has also been, not protein, but the CPG has also been shown not to be toxic. So okay. When you put them together and introduce them into the bladder, I don't think there will be any toxic response from the host, but clearly one has to do the safety studies.
Yeah. Is the hope then that it will be safe for use in children and during pregnancy?
So I don't see why it should be harmful to pregnant women or the fetus, because it's just focused on the bladder and the antibodies that you evoke would be circulating and should not have any side effects on the mother or the fetus. With regard to children, as long as they're able to evoke immunity, it should be okay with them. I mean, they are now talking of giving the COVID vaccine to young children.
Yeah.
And so this would be even, should be the same.
Okay, great. And is there, do you anticipate that there would be any interactions with other medications that people might be on?
Yeah, I don't know. I one will have to test. We can't predict any, but basically all we're doing is evoking antibodies in the circulation and getting certain T cells to come to the bladder. So I don't know, you know, if I don't see how it could maybe affect other drugs, but clearly one has to
take
the necessary tests.
This question might have a similar answer, but are there any anticipated allergies that people might have to the ingredients?
Yeah. So I can't think of any allergies to CPG that I've read about. And FMH, I also haven't heard of any reaction. So again, one needs to test that.
Yeah. And would there be any reason that you can think of that someone could not use your vaccine if they've used the previous UTI vaccine?
No, there should be no problem with that. I mean, we would, if they've used their previous UTI vaccine, this vaccine would maybe boost the responses to the other one as well. So we would get a higher maybe antibody levels circulating, but with regard to the T cells, only our vaccine is likely to bring in T cells into the bladder.
Okay. We got a whole list of questions about who this vaccine might be suitable for. So I might just ask you some of those. One is whether it will be suitable post-menopause.
Yeah, I should think so. So the critical requirement is an active, I mean, there should be no defect in the immune system of the recipient.
Okay.
And as long as the immune system is functional, it should be fine.
Okay. And what about in those who have been diagnosed with interstitial cystitis? Is it likely to provide any benefit there?
So if the trigger, because nobody really knows what triggers interstitial cystitis. Now, if the trigger is of bacterial origin, then a vaccine such as this that would eliminate hidden bacteria could be beneficial. Yes. But I don't think it's going to cause harm to them.
Right.
Only benefit.
Okay. And how about for people with spinal cord injury? Will it work in the same way?
It should work. Again, the key is their immune systems should be effective. And as far as I know, the immune systems are effective.
Mm-hmm.
So even if the bladder emptying and so on do not function as normal, but the immune system should be efficacious if you introduce the vaccine to the bladder.
Okay. The last one was chronic kidney disease. Is that likely to have other implications with the immune system?
So I don't know about this particular case. Chronic, if it has, I mean, if the origin is bacteria from the bladder, then it'll be protective.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, I don't know if it has any benefit to kidney disease that doesn't have any bacterial etiology.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's a bacterial etiology and it's bacteria coming from the bladder and so on, then maybe it'll be beneficial. But otherwise, I don't see benefit in chronic kidney illnesses.
Okay, so we've already had a lot of volunteers for your upcoming trial for this UTI vaccine. Do you have any idea when that may happen?
So that's the question that everyone asks. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, I don't have an answer. A lot depends on two things. So in contacting the National Institutes of Health in the US, we were told that we need to come up with surrogate markers to show that our vaccine works in humans.
Mm-hmm.
So we are currently determining what those markers are or what they should be when we go on to human studies. So we are doing those studies currently in mice to assess that. And then the other criteria is to get the funds for the clinical study,
mm-hmm.
Which includes undertaking safety studies and so on. So that's where we are. So we can't make any predictions.
Mm-hmm.
We're working on all fronts, trying to get funding, trying to undertake safety studies, and then also trying to figure out what the surrogate markers are or ought to be when we go into human studies. So it's going to take a few years before we get to the point of human studies the way things go now. Okay. But who knows? Now that there's a lot of interest in the success of COVID vaccines, mm-hmm. I think there may be a push from the NIH maybe to push some of these vaccines such as this forward at a much faster rate. Previously, the way they were approved took a long time,
mm-hmm.
but because of the success of the COVID vaccines, I think people are more willing to try out vaccines.
That would be great.
I'm hopeful. I'm really hopeful that this UTI vaccine will go to the next phase.
Mm-hmm.
In talking to the NIH officials too, they too seem very interested.
Okay.
In this particular vaccine, because it's novel and it makes sense when we explain the rationale behind our particular vaccine and our approach.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any insight into why it is so hard to access the vaccines on the market in the US?
Well, I think partly is there's not everyone is convinced that they work. So that may be part of the reason.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a lot of it could be due to lack of marketing and so on. But I would like to say that I think the current vaccine, because they are focused on generating just antibodies, I'm not sure they would be as efficacious as another vaccine, which also focuses on the T cells.
Mm-hmm.
T cells are key, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And we've always overlooked them in prior studies. But now with the recognition of the important role of T cells, I think vaccines targeting them and inducing recruitment of T cells into the bladder would be much more efficacious and long lasting in terms of efficacy, I think.
Some people have reported that when they can access the vaccines that are available, they're quite expensive. Do you have any notion of how much this new vaccine might cost when it's on the market?
Yeah, I have no idea. But I would think it might be more expensive because to introduce a catheter and so on, one would have to go to a physician's office, I think, than the standard vaccines. So there may be some increase in price, I guess. But again, I have no idea. I'm just
speculation.
And also, I think in terms of maybe insurance covering this, I think insurance would, because I mean, you know, diphtheria, pertussis, all of those vaccines which are protective and preventive are covered by insurance, including as well as meningococcal vaccines. So I don't see why this would not be covered.
That would be helpful, definitely. So what can we do and what can our community do to help make sure this vaccine trial happens sooner than later?
So I think what, I mean, the patient advocates and then being involved, I think goes a long way. I think persuading funding agencies and even, you know, in the venture capitalist field as well, convincing them of the need for such a vaccine could be beneficial. Sometimes I think a lot of the decision makers in industry and in the government are men, and they don't relate to urinary tract infections, I think,
because
most of the infections afflict women. And so the urgency for spending money on your UTI vaccines may not be there in their eyes. And I've been speaking from personal experience. When our work came out, I got called from the media, and I was surprised there were men, and I was wondering, oh, they seemed interested in UTI, but then they all told me it was their wives who convinced them to contact me. So it's always the men don't get the gravity of it. They all think that if you've applied antibiotics, that's the end of the story. But that's not the case. And I think with more of the patients getting involved and advocating for this, I think we could definitely speed things up. And especially now, as we were discussing earlier as well, with the COVID in all our minds and the vaccine working, pushing at this time for a vaccine would be an appropriate thing to do now.
Yeah, well, there's a lot of enthusiasm amongst our community for this. So if there is anything that we can do to help, you should let us know.
Will do.